not saying I support what is going on. In other words, this investment is one that can. I'm just giving an overall view. So it's just to say that I'm not at the moment. I'll wait and see what happens in the future.
I'm not quite sure what you did say.
Well, it's a support the £1 million investment.
You did say in one line.
Yeah, I'm sorry, yeah.
Thank you, Chair.
And then Steve.
I just want to make a suggestion. Maybe we can get a report or the groups, folks can put something together to go to a future meeting. So obviously, there's a lot of good questions.
Steve.
Yeah,
that's
true.
Just
want
to say one of the comments was about opening up access to here, there, and you mentioned Liverpool. Sometimes wonder, have we made it too easy access for Liverpool? Because Liverpool One is becoming very attractive to people now. We've put the two new big park and rides at Bidston and then North, which is encouraging people to jump on a train. We've already got every 3 minutes a train from Hampton Square to Liverpool. If we're building Birkenhead up, surely our social things are doing better access for Liverpool.
Did you want me just to attempt a bit
on the Liverpool?
There's a very brief response to that. But there has been in times past people who are parking Birkenhead go across to Liverpool to shop, and you're always going to get some degree of that. If you look at the two centres, obviously Liverpool is a city centre and it's higher up in retail hierarchies than Birkenhead is. Now, Birkenhead will never be Liverpool. What Birkenhead has got to develop is a complementary offer. If you look at the way retailing works in London, there's high footfall in Birkenhead, but it mainly comes from the east side of the borough. We've got lots of people there, but they don't spend a great deal of on the west of Wimble, we get quite a significant leakage of retail expenditure out of the borough in quite a number of people there will go to Chester or to Liverpool or to Cheshire Oaks primarily, as opposed to going into Birkenhead. We've also got the interesting position with Croft Retail Park, where that has expanded over the past few years. You'll have probably seen quite a lot of investment that's gone into there recently. So in retail terms in rural, it's quite a challenging set of circumstances. Within the town centre itself, one of the reasons why the regeneration hasn't happened in the way that we envisaged, and this is coming back to Councillor Mitchell's point, is that what we've seen over, say, the past 10 or 15 years is an investment company has come in and it's bought the town centre. It's then trying to develop plans on how it can invest in that. But then they take decisions 3 or 4 years later that they're just going to sell the asset. And then somebody else comes in. And then they look at it again and then they decide to sell on. And the current position we have with the owners of the Grange and the Pyramids is they've just done that. They came in, they had some very ambitious development plans, which I can't go into in a public setting. But really would have brought back quite a lot of regeneration and new retail offers for Birkenhead. But then they decided, because they're part of a larger organisation, to put Birkenhead into a portfolio and to sell it. And it was at that crucial point when we were just on the verge of actually getting some regeneration agreements with them. So it's extremely frustrating, but what we have difficulty controlling is the property market and the private sector owners and operators, because we can't do that. Where we are though now at the moment is that we've got the bid and the additional investment will come in from that. There's the investment here, and quite advanced on a number of retail redevelopment projects in the town centre, which again, I can't go into in public, but we're happy to talk to members about in a confidential session, maybe at a future meeting of the committee, if that's what members wish us to do. And we can just talk about the other things at that point as well. So hopefully that's helpful.
I'd just like to come in here as well, just to add my little bit.
got to remember, you know, is that we've got the business rates coming on top of us fairly soon. And if we're proposing to spend 1.1 million to try and open up the waterfront, and as Christine said about the success we've got down there, we can't get down there. And I'm at an advantage here. I'm actually from Liverpool, born and raised. And I can remember when the bus station was at the pierhead. And I can remember when the trams were there. But Liverpool then moved, as Christina said, they moved the bus depot from the pierhead up to Queen Square, which is now in the shopping precinct, which is what we do. But what we've got to try and do, surely, is open up the waterfront. It's a feature. We can't compete with Liverpool, we can't. But we've got to invest, surely, to... I live in West Will. I can't remember the last time I went to Birkenhead. I drove through Birkenhead today, through Charing Cross. I've been to a meeting. And it was depressing. All the pubs were closed. There was McDonald's open. It was appalling. And people from West Will, over that side, I'm not going. But if we can open up the waterfront, and Hamilton Square's nice, you know, we've got a nice town hall there, if we can open up that and reinvent, if you like, the Hamilton Quarter, I think it's something we should look at, because, as I said in my opening gap, we've got our business rates and we've got to seriously look. And this committee, a look at bringing in, and if it means investing 1.1 million, which is not a great deal, to try and bring people in, businesses in, and make them a success, as David said, not bringing them in and then they're selling on and then they're selling on and then they close. But that's just my observation, Christina.
Can I just say,
sorry, Ross. Christine, can you allow me? I'm sorry.
Rob,
I'm sorry. Then you,
Christine. Thanks, Jim. Two economies in Birkenhead. We all seem to be focused on modern data, the retail economy. Really, we should be putting a lot of our time and effort now in looking into the nighttime economy there. I don't go out in Birkenhead, and I do go out a lot, and I choose to go to Liverpool, and there's a good reason for that. I feel a lot safer in Liverpool that are doing Birkenhead. I suppose it's just a small community and then there's some kind of criminality going on there, so you're more likely to bump into it in Birkenhead than into the aftermath or the actual incident itself. But I think as a location, it's got a lot to offer, with the waterfront, the views, the buildings, where it is. So we need to look at that, because the two economies are similar. If you've got a lively daytime economy, it's going to lead into a nighttime one, whether it be cafe culture, bars, etc., that type of thing. So it would be a shame to see that side of Birkenhead being left behind. 1.1 million, you could build a decent bar for that these days. You know, so let's be honest, when you look at these figures, it's not a lot of money. Spent wisely, we could do something with it. But really, if we are going to revive Birkenhead, let's take it seriously, look at the big picture, and look at the investment we make and the returns that come from it. And that includes both the companies, day and night. You know, we really do have to look at the big picture here. That's going to include amenities, bars, policing, all the things that are involved in that. We have to make it into an appealing location as well that people want to go to. Now, the other thing is, you're faced with a choice. We either go to Birkenhead or you go to Liverpool. Once you make that choice, you're stuck, because commitment, you can't come back unless you get a taxi number. My daughter's 19 and I'm getting a lot of feedback from her friends who are students. They're on the middle and they'll leave after midnight, get a taxi back, try to get a taxi back. And they're greeted with this mantra, ooh, through the tunnel. It's going to be about £40 before we even start off. Little people are getting ripped off when they go to Liverpool. We need to do something about that. Instead of breaking up the tunnels and all that, no. We need to open them up. We need to put proper bus services on. So as people can visit Liverpool and come on the same evening, so to entice them back as well, as well as go. So we're not going to compete, but we can go for a few hours and come back. Today, yeah, I've got that option. That's what it was said.
I do apologise for you as well.
Just a couple of things very, very quickly, because I'm conscious of time going on. I'm trying to outline where we are in Birkenhead at the moment, but if you do pick up on Councillor Gregson's comment, and you think of it in this way, obviously we've got a city centre which is Liverpool, which has its vibrancy in the daytime, nighttime economy, its hotels, etc., etc. And it has a name and image for culture, and the development of culture, the heritage, the tourism. You think of the river, and then you think of cities around the world, or you think of Newcastle's gates, you know, and where you've got a river that's running effectively through two conurbations. And we are doing some significant work at the moment around the 2020 plan. Some councillors will know around the culture strategy, and Councillor Spriggs is the pledge champion on that. And what we're doing there is, in discussions with people like Culture Liverpool and a whole range of other people about how we can use the river, how we can animate the World Waterfront from New Brighton right the way down there, how we can do events on the river, how we can start things and develop that. Rose Boyle earlier on this evening mentioned to you about the devolution deal and the sums of money that's in there, and she also made mention that a prominent position is being given to culture within that. So I think there's something here through the devolution deal about building around the culture, the tourism, the heritage. Once we begin to build all of that, you then begin to build a nighttime economy, because it needs to be different to Liverpool. I think it is actually safer in Will than it is in Liverpool. There's perception issues there, but that then gives us opportunities to do your Woodside, your Hampton Squares, and back into Birkenhead Town Centre as a start. And now there's other things as well we need to look at, obviously the World Waters and how all that integrates into it. But I think we've got some significant opportunities and ambitions here, and the devolution deal just helps us to build on that. But probably the easiest thing, as a couple of members have suggested tonight, is if we were to do maybe a future meeting where we just focused on Birkenhead Town Centre, the waterfront and those types of issues. Maybe some of that would have to be just in a closed session if we want to share some of the commercial issues with you. But very happy to do that. It's the wish of the chair and the committee.
Mm-hmm. I just think if we want to revitalise Hampton Square and that area, why don't we use Birkenhead Town Hall for our meetings? Because it's far more central than Wallasey Town Hall. It's a far more impressive building.
It's not a war for me.
And finally, I mean, I could be here all night on these issues. I mean, there are heritage concerns in relation to the fact that we've stabilised the memorial. In how something else is there. So I know the heritage groups are concerned about the practice of this at the moment, but I do appreciate that the place does need to be opened up. And funny enough, I went to the AGM, the History Heritage Association, it's in Harrison Square, in one of the basements of the clubs, and I must admit, I went there at 6:30, 7 o'clock, it was absolutely dead down there, it really was. So there are. But the two sides. But the problem is the many of the armed forces, they're used to the pedestrianisation of the memorial area as well. So you've got that to deal with. But as far as opening up the waterfront is concerned, I mean, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, as you say, we're having the task and finish on tourism and how we exploit our tourism. I think it's one of the most important questions that we have to deal with, because we know that a vast amount of money is coming into the area and tourists and all these stuff from our area. You made it sound like a visit. But it is a really important
have to sort
this. Ladies and gentlemen, Move
recommendation,
yeah,
please. We're going to have that further report, Chair.
Yes, we have to read that, yeah.
And in that, will we go back to when we were first involved in Objective 1 funding? Because that was the first time anything was mentioned about the regeneration of the waterfront in relation to Birkenhead and Hamilton Square.
Yeah, I'll do my full history after the award. Let's move on, please. Item 9.
Move recommendation, Chair, to agree.
He agrees to that?
Agreed.
Well done. Okay, Scrutiny introduced by Mike Sullivan before. Committee agrees.
Agrees.
Any other business?
Negative.
Can I thank all the councillors? I think it's been a really good meeting tonight. It's been a really good fun.